Well, finally, tonight, a seminary primarily for British Catholic priests in Rome dates from the year 1579, and it includes the oldest British archival collection outside the UK.
Which opens in the crypt of Rome's Venerable English College on Monday, April 16th.
A mission has been on the property of the Venerable English College since the 1300s. The seminary primarily trains priests to serve in England and Wales, and its archive maintains more than 600 years of history. Joining us now from Rome is Monsignor Philip Whitmore, Rector of the Venerable English College in Rome. Monsignor Whitmore, thank you very much for joining us. We'll hear more about the archives in a bit. First, the seminary. How many seminarians are there right now, and what are they focusing on?
Hello there. Good to be with you. We have about 25 seminarians in the college at the moment, and most of them are from England and Wales, but we do have a fair number also from other places. We've got one from Canada, we have a couple from Ireland, and we have a good number from the Nordic countries, from Sweden and Denmark and Norway. So a bit of variety there.
Monsignor, are those numbers up or down, the 25 you said? Is that about right?
That's right, yes. Well, the numbers have gone up and down an awful lot in their history. When I was a student about 30 years ago, there were over 60 of us, but there have been times like the beginning of the 19th century when there were only about 12. So it's a long history, and the numbers go up and down.
Well, that's good to hear. Now, it's always a challenge attracting young men to the seminary. What are you finding that works? What works? What gets young men interested to become priests?
You know, it's wonderful how the Holy Spirit works, and particularly through things like World Youth Day, through pilgrimages to Lourdes, that's when he manages to touch people's hearts. And increasingly in these days of social media, of course, people are able to watch things that come like this and able to see our seminarians and the photographs and the social media posts they put out. And so they hear a bit about their lives and about the mission and about what they want to do, serving the people of God and bringing the gospel into their lives. In our case, we've got a long history, and the history goes back to the days of the martyrs, when we had people going back to England and Wales who were in danger of being put to death for being priests. But they still went. And that's a great encouragement to all of us, a great inspiration.
Let's talk about the archives. I know it goes back hundreds of years, got some amazing artifacts and treasures in those archives. Can you give me some samples, examples of those, what you have there?
I can do, yes, certainly. The reason it goes back so long is that even before we were a seminary, we were a house to receive pilgrims who were coming to Rome during the holy years. So back in the 14th century, we opened up as a place to receive English pilgrims. And we've got the pilgrim books there, recording who the people were who came to stay in the 14th and 15th and 16th centuries. But then if you go back to the early days of the seminary, which was after the Reformation, after the Council of Trent, it became a seminary, we've got the names of every student that ever passed through the college, and
wow,
quite a lot of biographical details about them. So that goes right back to the time of the martyrs. We've got their names recorded, and the names not only of the martyrs, but of every generation since, right up to the present. So when our new students arrive and their names are entered into the book, they can see it going right back to the beginning, to 1579, and they see the names of the martyrs. But we've also got some North American material, because in the early years of the 19th century, the Holy See asked my predecessors to be agents for the church in North America. So there were lots of letters that were written backwards and forwards from the early archbishops of Baltimore and Philadelphia. And our rectors, Robert Gradwell and Nicholas Wiseman, acted as the Holy See's agents. So there's a real treasure there waiting to be discovered. I've just glanced at it myself. Going back to the early days of the seminary, we've got a nice letter from St. Charles Borromeo saying the students were very welcome to call in on him in Milan on their way home. So a great variety of stuff there from different periods, going right back, as you say, to the time of the hospice, to the 14th century.
Wow, sounds like you could spend a year there and not get through it all. Monsignor Philip Whitmore, Rector of the Venerable English College in Rome, thank you very much. Very interesting.
Most welcome. Thank you for the opportunity.